Discover the secrets to achieving flawless precision in background blur with these masking techniques and transform your photos into stunning bokeh backgrounds using the Lightroom app. This is Nagesh and welcome to NavEdits. Let's dive right into this photo, which has an intriguing mix of background and foreground elements. We're going to work with the blur menu to enhance it. So what exactly does the blur tool do? It's not just about adding blur to the background. It gives you full control over the focus range, set the focus range and narrow down the focus range. We'll now see what we can do with this picture. Let's jump straight to the blur menu where I'll tap on the blur amount slider. This action triggers the app to connect to the cloud and initiate some AI-powered depth mapping. This automatically sets the focus range to the subject, saving us time and effort. Once we tap on the mask icon, we can actually see the depth map in action. The yellow areas represent what's more in focus. Now I'm going to crank up the blur amount to the maximum setting. Even though it's maxed out, there's a neat little trick we can use to add even more blur and really push the effect for a dreamy cinematic look. Tap on the focus range and you will immediately see a set of options to fine-tune it even further. Here's where the magic happens. By moving the focus range closer to the foreground, we can also narrow it down to create that extra layer of beautiful blur in the background. But be cautious, focusing too much on specific areas can make the rest of the image feel out of balance. To avoid that, I will expand the range slightly and place it right where the subject's face is. Notice how adjusting the focus range also subtly changes the depth and clarity. Now let's shift back to the subject itself. Alternatively, you can skip these adjustments altogether and use the point focus option. Just tap directly on the area where you want the focus and the app will do the rest, though you may still need to set the focus range manually. So the narrower the focus range, the more blur you can get. After applying the blur, the app processes the image on the cloud, giving us the output. This step can make the next one easier to not only enhance the overall look, also make the next adjustments easier, especially when we want to bring out more detail in the subject. Now let's head over to the detail menu and add some sharpness. By dragging the masking slider, we can fine-tune the selection even more precisely thanks to the enhanced blur in the background. With the mask set, remember that the sharpening effect will only be applied to the white areas of the mask. This allows us to sharpen the subject while keeping the background beautifully soft and blurred. Once you have adjusted the sharpening to your liking, you will see how the foreground becomes crisp and detailed while the background stays silky smooth, creating that stunning depth and focus effect we are aiming for. I have also got a great example here, a close-up portrait where this depth of field effect really shines. By adjusting the depth map, which we get after the AI processing, we can create some stunning results. Narrowing down the focus range gives the portrait that high aperture professional look with a beautifully blurred background that draws all attention to the subject. You can play around with the focus range and length to find the sweet spot that best suits your image. In this case, I will manually set the focus on the eye, which is key in portraits for creating that sharp, captivating gaze. Once the focus is set, I will head over to the detail menu to add some sharpening, bringing out even more clarity. After that, I will do a few minor tweaks like adjusting the contrast to give the portrait more dynamic feel. Once everything is dialed in, you'll save the final image. Sharper, more focused, with a beautiful bokeh effect that adds depth and drama to the shot. I have got this perfect example to show you how to achieve that stunning natural bokeh effect for city lights, a favorite among photographers. After applying the blur effect and letting the AI process the depth information, I'll start by increasing the blur amount to really enhance the separation between the subject and the background. You can see the depth map here. By narrowing the focus range, we can push the background even further out of focus, creating the dreamy blur that makes the subject pop against the cityscape. Once that's applied, I will dive into the bokeh options to fine-tune the look. You've got a choice here between circle and bubble bokeh shapes. Both can create beautiful results, but I'll go with the bubble option this time. In my opinion, it delivers a softer, more natural bokeh that works perfectly with the city lights, giving the photo that classic cinematic feel. After a few final adjustments, we'll see how this technique brings a gorgeous, polished look to the shot with the background softly glowing in those beautiful orbs of light. The transformation compared to the original photo is quite remarkable. After applying the blur and depth mapping, I will now head over to the detail menu to sharpen the image, just like I showed you in an earlier method. The added sharpness brings out more detail in the subject, making it really stand out against the beautifully blurred background. Now let's move on to some color grading to give the photo a more polished cinematic feel. I'll slightly mute the colors to give it a more refined, moody vibe, and then add a subtle touch of orange and teal tones to the overall image. As is sometimes the case with AI depth mapping, there are a few imperfections, in this case around the area where the subject is leaning. These small flaws can distract from the overall effect. We can easily fix this by cropping the image just enough to hide those imperfections while keeping the composition intact. With the final tweaks, the photo not only looks sharper and more vibrant, this is a prime example of how simple adjustments can completely transform an image into something captivating. Hope this video was useful to you all, and subscribe for more. See you in my next video soon. Thanks for watching.